Our top story this evening, I'm sorry. These were the words uttered by the man who's become the unofficial face of gambling in Australia. Bookie Tom Waterhouse has been back advertising on our screens tonight, but far less than usual after he promised to cut back on his aggressive marketing campaign following a public backlash. But it is far from enough, according to anti-gambling Senator Nick Xenophon. He joins us shortly. First though, Sarah Arbo looks at the latest in the Tom Waterhouse saga.
At TomWaterhouse.com.
TomWaterhouse.com.
At TomWaterhouse.com.
He's certainly a familiar face, infiltrating lounge rooms across the country.
With four generations of betting knowledge in my blood, I was born to bet.
Tom Waterhouse claims to know what punters want, but promises punters will now see less of him.
I realised when the PM came out so strongly last week, and also the public reaction that I had to change. Obviously, at the beginning of the season, if I'd known that it was going to be like this, I wouldn't have gone on the way that I did.
Despite that promise, before tonight's NRL clash, there he was again.
With Tom Waterhouse.
Well, I'm taking the Bulldogs on big time tonight. They're the short price favourites, but I'm going to offer way over the odds of $1.80.
The 30-year-old has recently spent weeks in the spotlight, becoming the public face of gambling. The backlash over bookies promoting live odds during sporting games reached boiling point, with the federal government announcing a crackdown.
From the moment they run on the ground to the moment they leave the ground, no live odds.
Today, in an open letter to the Daily Telegraph, the bookmaker apologised for the controversy he's caused.
Tom Waterhouse in our face. Really had people saying, why are my kids watching this? Why do they know about odds? Why are they lining up to get Tom Waterhouse's autograph, not their league or AFL stars?
Anti-gambling campaigner Tim Costello says the practice is damaging.
Live betting's dangerous. For young men, 16 to 24, 3 to 4 times greater gambling problem prevalence than any other form of betting. So the culture with those young men is it's impossible to think of sport without betting.
The betting man has gambled on his business. TomWaterhouse.com owns about 5% of the market, but he's spent more than $10 million on advertising. By the end of next week, bans on the promotion of all live odds by gambling companies and commentators will likely be in place, an impact that Waterhouse says he'll feel sorely.
I'm not trying to cry poor. I just love being a bookie and I'm trying to compete. And so, look, I could stop advertising, but I wouldn't have a business. And I've got to advertise to try and gain market share.
Well, anti-gambling Senator Nick Xenophon is certainly not sympathising with Tom Waterhouse, taking to the streets of Adelaide today to busk with one of the world's smallest violins. And he joins me now. Senator, the aim was to raise money for Tom. How was your stunt received?
Well, with bemusement. I mean, the whole idea was to take the mickey out of Tom Waterhouse. He's telling people that they should feel sorry for him. He's done a kind of an apology saying he's done too much. But really, the people that we should be feeling sorry for are the increasing numbers of Australians that are falling victim to sports betting addiction. And that's been driven in part because of the proliferation of gambling advertising during our sporting programs.
So what was the tally? Did you raise any money at all?
Look, somebody pretended to give me $20, but basically it was zero, so there's nothing for me to give to Tom.
Okay, and what did you make of Tom's apology today, Senator, to Australians? Will we see a genuine reduction in terms of the saturation of his and other gambling ads?
I think Tom Waterhouse has had to do this because of the public backlash and also because the regulations are going to be tightened up. He won't be able to spruik live odds during games, which is welcome, but we need to go further. I've had a bill in the Parliament for almost 2 years that basically says if it's a sporting program, no gambling advertising or during a G-rated period. The other thing is that Tom Waterhouse actually got his facts wrong. He said that gambling advertising doesn't really make any difference, that gambling expenditure, sports betting, has only increased in line with the CPI. The evidence given to a parliamentary inquiry on this indicates that it's gone up exponentially. One piece of research says that it doubled in 2010 to 2011 from $400 million to $800 million in losses. That's way beyond the CPI.
I understand that same report that you're referring to there, Senator, points to an estimate that by 2016, online wagering could grow to a total spend of upwards of $10 billion. Now, how do you measure the impact that would have on Australian families?
Well, I hope it's not going to become true, because we really need to act now as a community. We know that the level of problem gambling amongst young men in particular is going up and up because of the increase in sports betting. This is something that we need to address as a matter of urgency. What the Prime Minister announced a few days ago is only really tackling just the tip of the iceberg. We need to go to the whole issue of sports betting, advertising generally, and also some of the promotions and inducements offered for people to start gambling on sports. So we really need, as a nation, to tackle this as an issue, because if it gets out of control, that will be the next big tidal wave of problem gambling in this country, particularly amongst young men.
So much of the focus here has been on these live odds betting ads, which represent just 5% of the betting market in Australia. So how much further do we need these restrictions to go?
This is not a case of enough is enough. It's a case of enough is too much. We've got a situation now where we're at saturation level, where the overwhelming majority of Australians want to see a complete ban of gambling advertising during sporting programs, for the simple reason that they've had enough of it, and also their kids are being exposed to it. At the last State of Origin game, there were 300,000 children watching that game. I mean, if you want to change the culture, the direction we're going in, then we need to say enough is enough and let's ban this advertising.
It's a worthy aim, Senator, but do you think, though, it's a realistic one, given the amount of money that this industry is pouring into television revenues?
We can't not act on this because of the impact it's having on the community, on kids, on young people. And the question is this: if we don't wean off networks now from gambling advertising, it'll be too late in the next few years.
Senator Nick Xenophon, thanks for your time this evening.
Thanks very much.